Good evening and welcome. Please be seated. A very warm welcome to this service, which will take us far away. Tonight we will visit Japan and hear of stories of faith and passion from that land. Just a reminder that the next service in our sequence of Anglican services here will be a special service that comes outside the usual rhythm. We will be marking Ash Wednesday, that's next Wednesday, with a special service at 10 o'clock in the evening, a late night service of Allegri and Ashes, the beautiful music of Allegri's Miserere, the chance to reflect on our lives, and the opportunity to receive ashes for anyone who wishes. There are some postcards around, they're available at the back here. If you'd like to take them and give them to whoever might come. Now let us focus our minds, still our hearts. Oh, praise the Lord with me, and let us magnify his name together.
Thank you. reading from the book of Daniel. Then Nebuchadnezzar, in furious rage, commanded that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego be brought in. So they brought those men before the king. Nebuchadnezzar said to them, "Is it true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that you do not serve my gods, and you do not worship the golden statue that I set up? Now if you are ready when you hear the sound of the horn, pipe, lyre, trigon, harp, drum, and entire musical ensemble to fall down and worship the statue that I have made, well and good. But if you do not worship, you shall immediately be thrown into a furnace of blazing fire, and who is the God that will deliver you out of my hands?" Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered the king, "O Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to present a defense to you in this matter. If our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the furnace of blazing fire and out of your hand, O king, let him deliver us. But if not, be it known to you, O king, that we will not serve your gods, and we will not worship the golden statue that you have set up." Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you. from the book of Revelation. After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God, who is seated on the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne, and around the elders, and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne, and worshipped God, singing, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom, and thanksgiving and honor, and power and might, be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these, robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to the springs of the water of life. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." Here ends the second lesson.
Thank you. Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Encouraged by their example, may hold fast to the faith we profess, even unto death itself. The Lord Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commands, and also that by them we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior. We beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
kind of songs do you sing to pass time on a journey? It's a long way to Tipperary, it's a long way to go. The back of the bus, they can he sing, can he sing, can he sing. The back of the bus, they can he sing all day long. A thousand green bottles hanging on the wall. People often sing songs when they travel. Boatmen beat time with their oars and sing songs to keep in time. Sailors came up with ever more saucy sea shanties as they hauled the ropes so high. Soldiers marching as to war have often sung songs to keep their spirits up, to keep them moving as one body towards the place of fighting. The country is Japan. The place is a name that is familiar to us from other horrors, the city of Nagasaki. But hundreds of years before the dropping of an atomic bomb on that city, it was a place where there was great suppression of the new faith of Christianity that was being spread by Jesuit missionaries. Francis Xavier arrived in Japan to spread the faith in 1547. By the 1590s, there was great fear that the presence of Christianity would simply lead to the takeover of Japan by foreign powers, particularly Spanish powers. Tonight we remember the story of Paul Meakey and the 25 people who were killed with him on this day. This is the anniversary of remembering them. Their story is simple. Following a tip-off from a sea captain, they were arrested and condemned to death. No doubt to put off anyone else from joining this new religion. Their story is a classic tale of martyrdom. In the face of their oppressors, these 26 displayed enormous courage and kept on witnessing to their faith, even when it became absolutely clear they would die for it. And they were condemned to death in the city of Kyoto, and they were to be killed close to the city of Nagasaki. And to get from one place to another, they were marched. What kind of songs do you sing to pass the time as you are forcefully marched to the place of your death? What kind of songs do you sing to pass time on a journey? Well, as they marched, it is said that they sang words that we have just heard. In fact, we've had snatches of the Te Deum twice tonight, and we will have another go at singing it ourselves in our final hymn. The ancient Te Deum, a song of praise to God. As they marched, they sang. O God, we praise you. O Lord, we acclaim you. Eternal Father, all the earth reveres you. All the angels, the heavens, the powers of heaven, cherubim and seraphim cry out to you in endless praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are filled with the majesty of your glory. The glorious company of apostles praise you, the noble company of prophets praise you, the white-robed army of martyrs glorifies you. I don't know whether history records the color of their robes as they marched, but they certainly soon were to become martyrs. On their arrival at Nagasaki, they found that crosses had been laid out on a hillside site, and the process began of crucifying them one by one. They were to die facing the city, clearly being made an example of. Facing their crosses, they again began to sing. This time singing the Benedictus, another canticle, another thing that choirs sing. Something we say down in St. Mary's Cathedral every morning. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. executioners waited politely until they had finished singing their hymn and then took them one by one. As they were crucified, one of them, Paul Meakey, whose name is the one that we remember today, spoke from the cross on which he was hanging. And his words are called his sermon from the cross. In those words, the sermon of his whole life was revealed. He confirmed that, yes, he had preached Christianity. He was guilty of the things they charged him with. And yes, he was Japanese and not a foreigner. And yes, he forgave those who were killing him and his companions right there. And he prayed too that the blood that fell that day would flow out upon the land and sanctify it. Christianity was said to have been wiped out in Japan at that time. Those missionaries who were not killed were expelled. Churches were closed. The faith seemed snubbed out. However, missionaries returned in the 1860s and began to establish themselves in Japan again as that country opened up once more to the outside world. And when they did so, they found that in fact there were Christians in Japan. Thousands of Christians were found to be around the city of Nagasaki, whose faith had been kept alive whilst they had been cut off from the rest of Christendom by the stories of Paul Meakey and his companions. Those Christians kept their faith in secret. Missionaries to Japan found themselves being told stories of those whose faith had inspired generations of Christians to keep the news alive that Paul and his companions had been spreading in that land. The news that God is love, and that the love of God transcended even death. None of us tonight face anything like the pity, the tragedy, the pain, or the passion of being marched away to our deaths for simply being here and doing this, singing God's praises and praying for the world. But every one of us here is on our own journey. For each one of us, eventually, it will lead through the valley of the shadow of death. The witness of Paul Meakey and his companions gives us plenty to think about as we make our pilgrimage through life. As we go, step by step, on our human pilgrimage, what kind of songs shall we sing?
Let us pray. Let us pray for all those whose voices sing life's varied songs, for those who sing songs of joy, celebrating moments of triumph, gratitude, and happiness, and for those who sing songs of sorrow, mourning loss, seeking solace and responding to pain. Let us pray this night for those who sing songs of inspiration, igniting passion, creativity, and courage. for those who sing songs of faith, affirming hope, finding strength, and fostering connection with the Almighty. Let us pray for those who sing songs of unity, embracing diversity, promoting harmony, and fostering empathy among all people. And for those who sing songs of liberation, advocating for justice, freedom, and equality. And let us pray for those who sing songs of healing, seeking comfort, restoration, and wholeness. And for those who sing songs of remembrance, honoring the past, cherishing memories, and learning from their forebears. Almighty and everlasting God, as we offer our prayers for the singers of life's diverse songs, grant us the grace to harmonize our singing with yours. May our voices together create a symphony sounding out compassion, justice, and hope in the world. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.